Hey, what's going on? This is Seth with SethPerler.com, and today I'm going to tell you why I am going on a 10-day silent meditation retreat. It's called a Vipassana Meditation Retreat, where I'm going to spend 10 days in the middle of the desert doing nothing. So basically, Vipassana, V-I-P-A-S-S-A-N-A, is an ancient type of meditation. It's been around for a long, long time, and I've been meditating on and off for about probably 15 years now. And meditation has absolutely changed my life. It has taken me with my anxiety and panic attack disorder. I was in a coma a long time ago in around 2000. I came out of the coma and I was suffocating on my lungs. My lungs had stopped for about 9 days and I couldn't breathe. And so I was literally, my body was suffocating on the fluid that was in my lungs that was trying to protect me. And when I came out of that coma, whenever I would get short of breath, I would have an anxiety attack or a panic attack, because my brain had somehow connected the dots that when I'm getting short of breath, I might die, because when I was in the coma, I was on the verge of death every moment. And I don't know about every moment, but I mean, it was a touch and go situation. I was in ICU, it was very serious. So my nervous system is designed to protect me so that I can survive. So when I would get those triggers in my mind, I would feel anxious, which is supposed to help protect me. But the problem was that I wasn't in a place where I needed to be protected like that. I was safe, but my mind, my chatter of my mind, would really make me feel fearful and anxious, overwhelmingly so, that it was debilitating in my life. So it was a big thing that I had to work through. And one of the things that I did is I didn't want to go on medication, so I got a therapist who taught me meditation. I didn't know she was going to do this. I just specifically sought out a therapist who wasn't able to prescribe medication so that I knew there would be other modalities they were using. This happened to be a somatic therapist who was working with me with EMDR and somatic experiencing type techniques and with Vipassana meditation. That's one of the things that she taught me. And she told me to get the book. It was a Thich Nhat Hanh book. And I forget the title of it. If I find it, I'll put it in the show notes. But basically, it was my entrance into Vipassana and into what they call body awareness. Now, I'm not going to go into all the details about what this is. What I'm going to talk about is why I'm going to this thing. So here's what it is. I'm going on a 10-day meditation retreat, and it's a silent meditation retreat. So you drive out to Palm Desert. It's about 2.5 hours from Santa Monica, where I live now. And you go to this little retreat place, and you wake up at about 4:30 in the morning. And you might have a little bit of food. I think you start with tea or something if you want it. And then you go ahead and you start your first meditation. And then you eat a breakfast, a vegetarian breakfast. Then you start your second meditation. At some point during the day, you have a meditation teacher. And this teacher does not talk to you about anything except for this particular type of meditation. All they want you to do is focus on this one type of meditation. They don't want you to focus on anything else in your life. No other forms of prayer, no reading, no writing, no talking to anybody about anything, no exercise or fitness. You can take walks, but that's it. But the point is to saturate yourself in the ancient tradition for 10 days and really learn about the true nature of your mind and really be able to detach from the mental attachments that we have, from our thoughts and our mind that are not serving us. We have so much chatter in the mind, and this is designed to really help us slow down, become present in the present moment with whatever is going on in our body or whatever is going on in our mind, just to really slow down and be with that. And again, ultimately to help us be more present and less attached to our negative attachments or the things, our stories, our narratives in our mind that are not serving us. So I'm really doing this to obviously have a better quality of life. I've gotten so much out of meditation that I want to take it to, this is not for everybody obviously, but I want to take it to the next level and really have more peace in my life and more calm in my life and more clarity in my life about all the decisions I make day in and day out. I want a better daily meditation practice so that now I meditate most days for 10 or 15 minutes, but I really want a very consistent, solid practice. I want to learn more about myself and ultimately not only feel better in my own life and be more conscious and more aware of my own life, but be of better service to the people that I serve. And as you know, in my case, it's families with students who struggle with executive function, but my mission and my purpose with my work is very important to me. So I want to serve better. I want to live better, all of these sorts of things. So that is why I'm going on this 10-day retreat. So I will touch base with you after I get back, sometime after June 25th, probably that next Sunday. I'll send out a blog and let you all know how this retreat went and what I got from it. I've known many people that have gone. They have them all over the world. And this is a free retreat, your first one you're not even allowed to pay for. It's very basic everything, basic food, basic bedding, basic everything, just to get into doing this thing. And they really want to share this method because it's so beneficial to people. There have been so many studies on meditation. It goes with any religion. It doesn't matter what religion you are. It has nothing to do with religion, believe it or not. It's really about this present moment awareness, about getting into your body, about regulating your nervous system, at least to me it is, and having a better quality of life. So if you're interested in looking it up, look up Vipassana, V-I-P-A-S-S-A-N-A, Vipassana Meditation, and you can find out all of the different places around the world if there's one close by you, and you can really read about this method and if it works for you. So I will check back in with you soon. Hope you're having a great day. Take care.